Lastly, Anthony Gamble, ANTHONYGAMBLE, Public Information Officer of the Sacramento Police Department.
What happened?
So just after 3:15 this afternoon, officers responded to the 6500 block for reports of a shooting. Responding officers located one male with at least one gunshot wound. Unfortunately, that male was pronounced deceased on scene. Preliminary information tells us that there are two additional victims who have sustained gunshot wounds. I don't have the condition of them right now. They were transported to area hospitals. As soon as we get that information, we'll let you guys know. There's no suspects in custody at this time. We're asking the community to keep their eyes out. If you see something, say something, please call 911 or our non-emergency number, 916-808-5471, if you see something. Description that we have right now is two male black. One's wearing a black hooded sweatshirt with blue jeans. The other's wearing gray hooded sweatshirt with black jeans.
How old the suspects? Do you have any idea?
I don't have that information right now.
Did this happen on the train or off the train?
That's going to be something that's going to be part of the investigation. I don't have that information right now, but when investigators get here, they're going to process the scene, look at any available video that might or might not be available, and hopefully determine where that happened.
But you believe it happened on RT property, even if it wasn't on the train, somewhere around this?
That's correct. It did happen somewhere on RT property.
Was there a carjacking involved?
There is a carjacking. I can't say that they're related at this time. That's something that we're looking at as well.
Where was that carjacking?
Carjacking happened on Folsom Boulevard.
How far away from here?
I'd have to pull up the map to find out how far away.
In this general vicinity, though,
yeah,
you'd say?
Yeah, it's down the street. So.
Is it fair to say that you're looking into whether that was a potential getaway vehicle, that carjacking victim?
Yeah, absolutely. We'll look to see if there's any connection between the carjacking and this shooting and this homicide. That's going to be a part of the investigation. Our investigators will be responding out here, talking to witnesses, processing the scene, looking at physical evidence and digital evidence. Hopefully, if there is a connection, we're able to kind of tie that in very soon.
But all three shooting victims were all from this. It has nothing to do with the carjacking.
That's correct. All three shooting victims preliminarily are from this scene right here.
That was my question as well. The two that were taken to the hospital, were they found near here as well?
So I don't know where they were located. I do know that there's two additional, preliminarily, there's two additional victims that have sustained gunshot wounds that are taken to area hospitals.
Do you have any idea, one, the person who died, where they were shot, and the two people who are in the hospital, where they may have been shot on their body?
Yeah, I don't have that information, but I know our investigators, and then when the coroners get out here, they'll determine probably where those gunshots, where the victims sustained those gunshots, and then the people at the hospital, same thing. Our officers get out to that hospital, hopefully figure out where they were in relation to the shooting, and then obviously we'll document where they were shot.
Does RT have cameras that you guys would be looking at to help in this?
Yeah, absolutely. We'll be looking at any available video that may or may not be available to us.
And so you said that the victim who died on the scene there. The victims that survived, were they self-transported? Was the ambulance transported?
Yeah.
And where were they located?
Yeah, I don't have that information of whether they were transported by ambulance or self-transported. And again, I don't know where they were located. I just know that preliminary information tells me there's two more victims at area hospital at this time.
And it's your belief that both of the suspects that you are now looking for, both of them are armed?
Yes.
Would you consider them armed and dangerous?
Absolutely. We'll consider them armed and dangerous. And we ask the community, if you see something, please say something, call our non-emergency number or 911 if you see somebody matching the description.
Were you able to get permission
to
step into other people now?
No, not at this time. When I am able to, I'll send it out on the signal.
Do you expect any more updates sometime this evening?
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. There'll be more updates in the signal, and then once we get everything, all the information that I can provide, we'll do a news release and put that out.
Okay.